own woodman.
Okay. All right, we're about to start. Well, I've got a bunch of logs here. I got to get, I guess, prepared to dry. Now, the best way that I do is I use a wax to seal the ends of all the boards. That helps prevent the moisture from drying out of there too quickly. Now, you ask, if you're trying to dry the wood, why are you trying to seal it in there? Well, the main reason is a lot of us know that as wood loses moisture, it shrinks a little bit. And if one part of the wood loses moisture quicker than the other part, they're going to have, you know, kind of a separation, and it's going to check, it's going to crack, and then that makes it useless on the lathe or for other types of woodworking too. So what you want to do is let this wood dry as slow and evenly as possible. Now, since the end grain loses moisture so quickly, that's what we got to seal off. We want most of the moisture to be lost through the bark, through the side of the log, and then that will ensure that, you know, the ends don't crack and that it's dry all the way through. Now, it takes a long time to dry, so if you're wanting to start a project and you've got to dry your logs, this is probably not the way to do it. They say, you know, wait a few months to a year for this stuff to dry out. And I just say, wait, the longer the better. As patient as you can be, that's the way to go. Now, the method I use isn't very expensive. I just, you can use what I used to use is a coffee can and some candle wax from those long glass candles you find at the grocery store, like prayer candles, I believe. I just melted them down, tossed them in here, and then I can heat those up on, you can use your stove, or I just got this portable stove here, real cheap on Amazon. And while I was shopping for my wax, I came across this little stew cooker on Amazon. It was cheap, like $20 or $25, so I thought, hey, let's just make a dedicated pot for my wax. And then I also got a 10-pound block, because I've got a lot of wood here to do. So I thought, let's just do this together, show you how to do it. Obviously, we gotta melt this wax. I don't know how much to do. Maybe this much is good. I'm gonna put it on a dowel. Let's see if that helps it break. Pretty good. Let's see if that'll be enough for now. Well, while I got the wax melting, I'm going to address all these knots and rough edges. It makes no sense to keep those on. You're not going to use this for any project. So I'm just going to cut them off so I get a smooth edge that I can apply wax to. And this whole face, I can just apply wax to that too. I don't have to worry about that. But I'm going to clean up this knot here and these ends that are all cracked. Now, what I do for small pieces that you can handle, I like to just dip it in there, dip it into the bucket. And for the larger pieces or for big faces, I like to use a brush, wipe it on there. Now, it's not critically important that you coat that there's no air holes in there. It's okay to have a couple, because what we're doing is slowing the wood from drying. And, you know, a decent heavy coverage will be good enough. Now, some people recommend using mineral oil and wax. I don't recommend that simply because the mineral oil is going to absorb into the wood, into the cell tubes. It's going to go deep into the wood, and that's going to keep it moisturized, which is not what we're looking for. We're looking to slowly dry it, so we don't need to moisturize it at all. In fact, the oil, as far as I'm concerned, will hurt the wood in the way that when it comes time to finish your project, whatever you're making, if that wood is absorbed into here and you turn this into something, you know, a bat or something, that oil is going to prohibit you from using any kind of like water-based finishes. Oil and water don't mix. So you can't use any type of water-based, or it could even affect some of your other finishes too, and stain the wood and all that. So I don't recommend doing that. Wax is going to be perfectly fine because all we're doing is sealing the wood. We don't need to moisturize it at all. And in fact, some of those store-bought wood sealers, I just don't see the point in that. All we're doing, like I said, we're just putting a coat on here to prevent water from coming out the ends. This is a perfectly fine barrier, and it's cheap. Now, another cost-saving thing is sometimes I use those heavy-duty tinfoil roasting pans you can find at the grocery store. They're $3 or $4. That works perfectly fine on the stove. Just cook it nice and slow. You don't want to put it on high or anything. We're not trying to get this wax to boil. In fact, I had mine set at 200, and I did a temperature check, and it was only like 175, so it doesn't take a whole lot. And that's definitely a cheap way to go. Now, I'm kind of doing this slow because I'm talking. I got to think about what I'm saying, but you know, you could have had a couple boards done already. Anyway, set that aside and let that cool a little bit. Let's go on to another one. Now this has a large amount of bark missing on the side here, so I'm going to use my brush for that. Now that mineral oil and wax, I think that's great for other purposes. I personally use that for my, when I make my spoons, and I want to have a food safe sealant on it to help it last longer. You know, it goes in and out of a hot, you know, pot of pasta sauce or something like that. It's really taxing on the wood finish. So what I do, I've got another video, I'll put a link to it, making a spoon and then finishing it with the beeswax and mineral oil, which is food safe. I found it in the pharmacy. You drink that stuff as a laxative, so it's okay to go in your body. I mean, you're not sucking on the spoon. It's just to finish. I'll put a link in that in the bottom though. But I use that for my spoons and it works great because the oil helps it get absorbed deep into the spoon. And I do the same thing. I heat it up in a roasting pan, and all that heat pulls all the air out of the spoon, out of the wood. And then as you turn it off and it cools, that oil and wax is sucked into the wood with the absence of air. It sucks it back in, so it gets nice and nice deep penetration. But for this you don't want to do that. We don't want to have anything really going into the wood. Just trying to make a barrier. Now this has already started to check, and this top piece is pretty beat up, but who knows, in the future, I'm not sure what project this is going to be, but we'll just protect it while we got the wax ready. Now when you've got your wood done, set it aside and let it dry for a few months to a year or more. The longer the better. And your wood will dry out slowly through the wall. And for the most part, be check free. Thanks for watching.